Okay, let's move on to continuation, because Moltres was the only thing that was in here. I know I have a tendency to forget to switch my Pokémon around whenever a level up has happened. Dirk, you need to go up here, because otherwise someone else is coming first. You're a rock type, so Dirk is a good bet. But I don't really want to waste PP of my good moves, so... Well, you're half of my level, so self-destruct doesn't really scare me in your situation. As long as the experience points count. Trainers lift seek stronger opponents. Yeah, where are those stronger opponents? Because everything I've met so far up to this point wasn't really something you can call strong. Okay, Parasect, level 43. It's getting close, but still can't really call this strong. Let's just throw some rocks at you. Well, it's able to take it, so I can give you that. Get rid of you. Dewgong. That's interesting. Let's put Zappa in so we can take it out quickly. Evolved form of Seal. Either it's been a while since we've seen it or we haven't seen it at all yet. I can't really remember it, so it might be a new Pokémon by this point. Even at the end of the game, we're still meeting new types of Pokémon, you might say. Once again, I'm still not too sure because I've met so many Pokémon the last couple of weeks in this game. I'm not really sure which ones we have or haven't seen. So my apologies if this wasn't the first time. At least I can't remember it, so... It was probably the first time. And Chansey might also be new. We've seen one in the Safari Zone, that I know. I didn't catch it, but still. We did see it. But actually, fighting one, I'm pretty sure we haven't done yet. Chansey has very, very high HP. It's one of the biggest traits of Chansey, normal type. Known for having super high HP, so taking this guy out without super effective moves might take a while. But I'm way higher level, so taking me out is also going to take a while. Yeah, there we go. Critical hit Sky Attack is super powerful. Even a Chansey can't take it with its high HP. Let's go. Okay, what more are you hiding over here? There's lots of trainers down there. Okay, let's go do you first. Only the chosen one can pass here. You shall not pass! Why is that the first thing coming to mind? Three Pokémon, and one of them is a Kingler. Evolved form of Krabby, with way too big claws. That doesn't look healthy. Yeah, be careful for Crab Hammer. All these crab enemies, both Kingler and Krabby, no Crab Hammer, which one of the most powerful water type moves in this game. So having a ground type out might be a bad idea, but somehow I lived. Yeah, I'm out of here. One more move I was able to take with this Kingler, but another water type, I'm not going to survive. Bye, Dirk. See you later. Zappa, you need to take care of this guy. Okay, thank you for using an attack move, because you're not going to get an extra turn, and that was a waste of turn. I know Thunder is stronger, but Thundershock never misses, so that's a more safe move to use in a situation like this. Okay, Blastoise. We know how to take down a Blastoise. We fought Bob more than enough times. Yeah, that's what I mean. Oh, he's actually using Skull Bash, it seems. So, yeah, luckily this time it did connect. That's the downside of these super powerful two-turn moves. You do need to have two turns for it. We win. Luckily we do, because if we start losing to these trainers, what chances do we have against Elite Four? Those are way more powerful than these guys. I'll show you just how good you are. Well, if you don't mind, I will do that myself. You can help, of course, because I do need to face someone in order to show that. Bellsprout. Oh man, that looks as something that can beat my Dirk, so... Let's get to Clement quickly. Otherwise, this is not going to end well. Flamethrower. Same kind of deals with Thunder and Thundershock. Fire Blast is more powerful, but Flamethrower is more reliable. So if you don't necessarily need to use a super powerful move, it's better to just use a little bit of a weaker move. But with more guarantee that you actually connect. Because just like Thunder, Fire Blast also has a very high chance of missing. No, interesting, he actually had Bellsprout, Weeping Bell, and then Victory Bell. All three in the same evolution line. All three Pokémon that I'm never going to get in this version. Pokémon Blue exclusives. And no matter what, they can't stand fire, so they're gone. Oh, it was a female. It was a female trainer. That shows how good I'm paying attention here. I'm so distracted, I did not even see what kind of a trainer I was facing. I thought it was a cool trainer male, but it was a cool trainer female. And here we have the... Okay, never mind. Battle first. Okay, let's try to finish the story now. Here we actually find another rock. This one is actually placed beside a hole, so it's pretty clear what we need to do. Let's follow it, because otherwise we're not able to use it, obviously. New screen, so we need to use strength again. Whenever entering a new screen, you need to reinitiate all of your moves whenever you're using them, like strength. Try to push this to the left. Because I can remember the switches there. I also see a trainer up there. Just remember, you don't actually have to fight this guy, because we have already been in this room. We're just here to place the rock on this switch over here. Because we didn't have a rock available to us the first time we went through here. But this is actually a room we've already been to. Okay, now that this location is accessible, we can actually go over here and find ourselves the exit. Thank you very much. There's also an item here, by the way. Nothing too important, but still, you can pick it up if you have room to carry it. And with that, Victory Road is taken care of. Right now, the game still considers us at Route 23, as you can see, but we're past Victory Road. The dungeon is done. The only thing we can do now is take on this final stretch towards the Indigo Plateau, the ultimate goal of trainers, Pokémon League headquarters. Let's go. This place can be annoying, because all these statues here can make a little bit of a maze situation, as you can see. I'm not really too sure why they did that, but it is simply the case. The screen turns indigo, the dark shade of purple, indicating we have arrived at the final town of this game. And now that we have arrived at that game, take this in mind. It is now available to us as a fly location. Because this place over here actually functions as a Pokémon Center, as you can see. Even though the Indigo Plateau itself does not have an official Pokémon Center, this building is a Pokémon Center. So it still counts as a fly location. So if you want to leave here, if you're not really done with something and want to take care of other business, be free to leave. As soon as you enter the purple screen, the Indigo screen, this location becomes available to you. So you can easily get back here. So if you still have some errands to do, do that now. Because the end of the game is coming up quite soon. And remember, this Pokémon Center is the final location where you can heal up the Elite Four that we're going to take on in a minute. force you to do it all in one go. The Elite Four, you cannot back out. You cannot go back quickly to a Pokémon Center to heal up for the next trainer. You have to do all four of them in one go. It's the first time in this game that actually works like that. So far, whenever we faced gyms, we were able to go out and heal up or whatever. No worries. No longer the case. This is the final time you're allowed to heal up and to level up. So do that quickly. Because you can't while you're busy fighting. Okay, I think I'm ready. So, as soon as you've done all of your business, get your A-team ready. Make sure you have leveled up enough times. You should be at least at around level 50, a little bit above it, in order to make this part of the game doable. And then it's time to head in. Remember, there's still a shop here, so if there's a couple of healing items you want to buy, do that now. There's also Ultra Balls you can buy here, but that would be a waste because there's nothing to catch. We're only facing the Elite Four. This is the true Pokémon League. But healing items you can still buy, of course. From here on, you will face the Elite Four, one by one. If you win, a door opens to the next trainer. Good luck. And even though the game doesn't specifically say so right now, you are not allowed to go back, but I will point that out. We will automatically head towards the first trainer. As you can see, the door is locked. We actually have to beat this guy. Or this girl, I must say. It's a woman. Welcome to the Pokémon League. I am Lorelei of the Elite Four. No one can best me when it comes to the icy Pokémon. Freezing moves are powerful. Your Pokémon will be at my mercy when they are frozen solid. Hahaha, are you ready? I know how ice moves work. I have my Eve. I have my art. First trainer is Lorelei. The Elite Four will begin. And as she gave away already, she's going to use ice-type Pokémon. The first trainer in this game that's exclusively going to use ice-type Pokémon. First one being a Dewgong, level 54. Higher level than me. So if you were worried I was overleveling in this game, first Pokémon that Elite Four throws out is already higher level than mine. So I will simply win this battle by using super effective moves. Cloyster is the second one. It's also a water type, so Zeppa is still the best bet. Okay, he will get a move in. He also gets paralysis. So he doesn't get a move in. Thank you. Let's finish you off. A little bit of luck sometimes also helps. Level 54 for Zeppa. Next one is Slowbro. That's not an ice type, Lorelei. But it is a water type, so Zeppa still works. Oh, Amnesia. That's actually a pretty powerful move to raise special. So don't give a Pokemon who uses Amnesia the chance to actually attack you. Because it actually raises special by a lot. It's a psychic type move, officially. And speaking of psychic types, Jinx. Pretty sure we haven't faced those yet. Psychic and ice type. Also knows Ice Punch usually, so let's go use Clement on you, because fire type moves are effective against ice types. The first time I actually have to mention that, because like I said, it's the first time we're meeting a trainer that exclusively uses ice types. Even though Slowbro officially is not an ice type. But Lapras is. Lapras is also water type, so Clement is not a good idea anymore. Let's return to Zeppa. Let's try to thunder you. Okay, works immediately. Even though you're two levels higher than me, it should still take you out in one hit. And that is how powerful Thunder is. Even higher level Pokémon you can take out in one hit, as long as it is super effective. And the first trainer is down. How dare you? No, that's all she had to say. You're better than I thought. Go on ahead. You only get a taste of Pokémon League power. Yeah, this was only the start. The real deal's yet to begin. And if you move on, You will find out if you try to go back someone's voice. Don't run away. Like I explained at the beginning, we're not allowed to leave. The Pokémon Center is out of our reach. No matter how hurt you are after the first battle, or the second, or the third, you have to continue. And this rocky room is going to be the next trainer. So, let's make sure a decent Pokémon is up. Because Zappa is not going to be of good use here. He will have fighting types, so Howard is the best bet. I am Bruno of the Elite Four. Through rigorous training, people and Pokémon can become stronger. I've weight trained with my Pokémon. Oh god. Treecks. We will grind you down with our superior power. Hoo-ha! Okay, the fighting dojo master is going to look like a joke compared to this guy. Say hello to Bruno. He also has a lot of rock types, if I remember correctly, in all versions. Not really sure how many, but Onyx is apparently one. But most of all, this guy is a fighting type trainer. And the way he's talking about weightlifting with him, I'm pretty sure he can also put himself in the ring and also do pretty decently. Here we have the first actual fighting type, Hitmonchan. Higher level than me, but a fighting type, so my psychic power should take care of him quite easily. There we go. And he's going to put a Hitmonlee right behind him. He really does look like the fighting dojo master from Saffron City. Who also used Hitmonchan and Hitmonlee. There we go. Another Onyx. Yeah, let's give somebody else a chance. Howard has done enough in this battle. So let's freeze your rocks. There we go. Machamp. Okay. I was getting more and more convinced that guy wasn't in this game, but apparently he still is. Bruno actually has one. Don't know why I forgot about that, but here we have the final evolution of Machop and Machoke. Machamp. You do need to have the ability to trade in order to get this guy yourself. But at least we are able to see him this way. Because I cannot get him. Ooh. He tried to one-hit KO me. Luckily it didn't work. But there's always a chance, of course. Fisher is a move that can take you out in one hit, no matter what, if it connects. But luckily, rarely connects. How could I lose? My job is done. Go face your next challenger. Okay, not too much damage so far, luckily, so no healing required. And we enter the graveyard, it seems. Can you guess what the type of this woman is going to be? Can already give that away. Officially it's ghost, but since there's only a limited type of ghost types in this game, this one is more of a poison type trainer, but still. I am Agatha of the Elite Four. Oak's taken a lot of interest in you, child. That old duff was once tough and handsome. And that was decades ago. Now he just wants to fiddle around with his Pokédex. He's wrong. Pokémon are for fighting. Treecks, I'll show you how a real trainer fights. Okay, say hello to the ghost type trainer of the Elite Four, who doesn't really have a lot of ghost types. It's more of a poison type trainer. Especially since all of the ghost types in this game are also poison types, so... And the reason I'm saying that is because we are going to want to attack that poison type. So make use of moves that are strong against poison types, and even on the ghost types it will work, because all of the ghost types in this game, Ghastly, Hunter and Gengar, are also poison types. So make use of that weakness. Okay, here we have a flying and poison type. Golbat. For you, we can actually use your weakness against electric attacks because you're a flying type. I could have just filled Agatha up with two Ghastlies, two Hunters, two Gengars, and she would have been officially a fully ghost type trainer, but they didn't do that. Luckily, they didn't. She's also carrying around a couple of generic poison types, as you can see. But okay, here we have the next ghost type, Hunter. So, let's move back to our ground type. We can use moves that are strong against the poison types. Let's use Dick, we have more of those. Since we have to do everything... oh! Well, it's another poison type, so it'll still work. She actually switched Pokémon, but it didn't really help her. Okay, Hunter. Second time's the charm. Okay, now we're going to get you because you didn't switch out now. Level 55. It sounds intimidating, but in all honesty, isn't really. And another Gengar. The final one. Ooh, level 60. Man. Watch this. It's still going down one hit. Yeah. Super effective for the win. There we go. That was three. Only one more to go. Oh ho. You're something special, child.